சார் கொஞ்சம் ஒட்டியாச்சுங்க சார், நீங்கள் அவர் கூட ஒட்டியாச்சுங்க. அந்த பக்கம்
Good.
Okay.
ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஜம்ப் வந்து நீங்கள் பாஸ் பண்ணும்போது எனக்கு வந்து இது வந்து பண்ணால் எனக்கு வாழ்க்கையில் இது சேஞ்ச் பண்ணால் எனக்கு ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் ரெடியூஸ் ஆகிடும்னு சொல்லிட்டு தான் த்ரோ பண்ணுறீங்க ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பால். செகண்ட் ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட் நீங்கள் த்ரோ பண்ணுங்கள், யானை பிடிங்க, நூல் விட்டுறாதீங்க சரிங்களா, ஒரு நல்ல ஒரு டாப் வெப்பாக அது ஃபார்ம் ஆகும். ஓகே ஆல்ரைட் ஸ்டார்ட். நீங்கள் தூக்கி போடும்போது ரெண்டமாக தூக்கி போடலாம், தூக்கி போடும்போது இது வந்து என் வாழ்க்கையில் இல்லைன்னா எனக்கு வந்து பெட்டராக இருக்கும், ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் இல்லாமல் இருக்கும், இல்லாட்டி ஆன்சைட்டி வந்து கம்மியாக இருக்கும்
போனா தெரியும் சார்
சென்னையில இருக்க
முடியும்
கேட்டாவே போதும், நம்ம சொன்னோம்னா அதை கேட்டாவே போதும்.
இருக்கிறோம்
mental health and hypertension. A lot of people talk about mental health and a lot of people talk about hypertension too. And with this day being very important for people who are undergoing hypertension or who have who've been diagnosed with hypertension, I think it's something that we'll have to talk in terms of what kind of psychological benefits we can be giving, what kind of psychological help they're already getting. So why do psychologists play a part with people diagnosed with hypertension or with any connection to do with hypertension is all about how we can help them handle what happens after the diagnosis. So a lot of times there is always a misinterpretation that, you know, because they're always stressed or always anxious, they'll probably have more chances. Yes, but not in a big or very big statistic. But I think we should be looking at what happens right after. So when you're diagnosed with hypertension, the way that you react to it and the way that you feel every single day. So if you tell yourself, like, you know, don't think about this, you're going to always be thinking about this. So that's something that's very similar when it comes to when you're diagnosed with hypertension. When they keep telling you, don't be stressed, don't be tense, take things slowly, all of those things never help or isn't usually something that will help you and not want you to be talking or thinking about it. So what we do as psychologists is we help identify what kind of triggers or what kind of stressors are, you know, continuing you for having hypertension or is helping with the condition. So we try and understand what are the small things in life that if you change or if you see differently. So we try and work on a lot of perspectives. A perspective about an event or a problem that you have is and how you can change that perspective, how you can change the way you think about that perspective is going to change the situation in itself. So we do something, or the therapy that we use is called cognitive behavioral therapy, which is a major therapy that they use, where you change your cognition, you change thoughts, you change your thinking patterns, your the way you make decisions, all of those things are changed. And when you change the way you think about a situation, it'll change the way you feel about it, and hence it changes the way that you behave after. So we go in with the assumption that the behavior or the consequence is something that is causing more and more hypertension and isn't allowing the person to take rest or isn't allowing the person to de-stress or live a life with lesser triggers or lesser or better harmonial well-being as such. So with that being said, here we are, and I think this is a profession that goes on and has a lot of tension, a lot of stress on a day-to-day basis, and with a lot of adrenal rush that happens with them. We're just here not with the prognosis that, you know, that, or not with already the assumption that they're all people who are always going to be stressed and always being going to be anxious, but not necessarily that way. But just if they are, if they do, what is it that we can do from a mental health aspect? What is it that we can give them and teach them some kind of technique, some kind of ways to handle if they do feel very tense or very pressured and very stressed as their day-to-day activities or because of their profession?
So what is the main subject for today's?
Okay, so the main purpose for today is we help them identify. So we teach them through activities a couple of ways where they can identify what is something in my life that always causes me stress or is constantly causing me stress. So they try and identify certain things like that. Example, if it's a relationship issue or if it's a work-related pressure or if it's a particular person or if it's a particular event, like, you know, I always get up late, so I come late, and that is a major stress that I always have. So those kind of things they pick out, identify, and through an activity understand how they can let it go. We also teach them ways of how they can handle so basically it's also called mindfulness, where they take a minute or so and help and identify what are the things around that they can change. So we're also doing a team building, or we're doing a support system work that happens in the organization, where each of them will help each other when they notice the other is feeling anxious or they notice the other person is feeling stressed. So it helps in having a collaborative way that they're all in this together and they can support each other too. Okay? All right.